Welcome one and all. Today we will learn how to make class 1 cavity preparation on mandibular second molar. First we will gather all the instruments which are required. First and foremost we require typodont or iverine teeth, followed by burrs, diamond point. We will require round, straight fissure burr, tapered fissure and inverted cone burr. When we make class 1 cavity preparation on mandibular second molar, first we have to use round burr which is placed parallel to long axis of tooth in the central fissure. Followed by that, we acquire initial depth of the cavity, that is 0.2 mm in the dentin. That we, from that point we extend from mesially as well as distally so as to acquire cavity shape. We extend from the central pit to mesial and distal along the central fissure. And in the center, we extend buccally as well as lingually into the buccal and lingual fissure. When extending mesially as well as distally, we have to keep in mind about the marginal ridge. We have to preserve marginal ridge. So the thickness of marginal ridge is about 1.5 mm, both mesially as well as distally. To start, we have to keep round burr parallel to the long axis of tooth. Now we will change from round burr to straight fissure burr so as to extend mesially as well as distally. Now we have changed burr from round burr to straight fissure. We will keep in the center of tooth and extend mesially as well as distally. Use chip blower for remove debris from the cavity surface. Extend the cavity mesially. Prepare dovetail mesially as well as distally along the triangular fossa. Move straight fissure burr along cusp so as to achieve cavity shape. you should achieve about 1.5 mm of depth from the central fissure of a cavity. This you can grossly measure with the help of straight fissure. As straight fissure burr is around 3, the working end is around 3 mm. So you should achieve depth of about 1.5 mm, that is half of straight fissure burr. Now you have to change burr from straight fissure to inverted cone diamond point, and the final depth of about 2 mm is achieved. Now, just before doing this, you should check intermittently with the help of straight pointed probe if the floor is smooth or not. If it is not smooth, then if you get any obstacle or any if the probe stuck to any point, then you should remove it with the help of burr, that is straight fissure, or with the help of inverted cone. So with the help of inverted cone, you can achieve occlusally convergent wall, which is mandatory for retention form of amalgam restoration. So this inverted cone is placed parallel to long axis of tooth, and it should move along the buccal and lingual walls. With this inverted cone, you can achieve convergent wall as well as smooth pulpal floor. Remove all the debris with the help of chipler. Again with the help of pointed straight probe, you check smoothness of pulpal floor. Now you can see that the probe is moving smoothly onto the pulpal floor. This means that there is no hindrance to the Now after using inverted cone, this is the final shape depth of the cavity. Here you can see that the marginal ridge is preserved adequately with 1.5 mm thickness on mesial as well as distal side. Then secondly, you can see that the buccal and lingual walls are occlusally convergent. You can check with the help of straight probe that the occlusal walls are convergent or not. The other point which you should remember, that is buccal and lingual finger extensions, which are given in buccal and lingual fissures. And we have achieved final depth of about 2 mm from the central fissure. This we have to place 0.5 mm thickness of base followed by 1.5 mm of amalgam restoration. Now we'll go for base followed by amalgam restoration. Then we have to use zinc phosphate cement as a base, which acts as an insulating material for class 1 cavity preparation. We have to take powder and a liquid on a glass slab. We have to divide powder into small increment and a large increment, and a drop of liquid. While mixing, first we have to take small increments and fold it into liquid, followed by that larger increments. The powder liquid ratio for mixing zinc phosphate cement is about 2.5:1. So we will first mix smaller increment into the liquid, and we have to spread, we have to mix in a circular motion and into larger surface area, as it is an exothermic type of reaction. After reaching dove stage of the cement, we have to use cement carrier plastic instrument for carrying the cement from glass slab to cavity, and we have to use powder or spirit as a separating medium for the instrument so that it does not stick to the instrument. To carry this cement, zinc phosphate cement, with the help of cement carrier and place into the cavity. With the help of condenser, condense cement onto the cavity surface. Now after condensing, we have condensed like more amount of base into the cavity. Now we have to finish. So while finishing, small amount of base is removed. So we have to finish with inverted cone burr only. And again we have to place, keep in mind that the burr is parallel to long axis of tool. Now we have to use inverted cone burr for smoothening base. And we have to place this burr parallel to long axis of tool. We have completed base and we have smoothened purple floor with the help of inverted cone burr. We have to remember few points while applying base and after completion of base. First and foremost, we have to keep in mind that the base should not left onto the cavity walls, that is buccal, lingual, distal and mesial walls. If it is present, then we have to remove with the help of burr or spoon excavator. Secondly, the depth. After application of base, the depth of the cavity from the central pit should be around 1.5 mm, which is for amalgam restoration. After application of base, we have to move on to amalgam restoration. So armamentariums required for amalgam restoration are shown. First, mortar and pestle, then mercury, Cavendish and gauze for squeezing. The steps for making amalgam as a restorative material are, for first and foremost, you should take proper ratio, followed by that trituration, then squeezing of excess mercury, mulling with the help of muslin cloth or with the help of gloves, then placement of the amalgam on the opposite end of dappen dish, followed by taking that amalgam from dappen dish to cavity with the help of amalgam carrier. We take powder in a ratio of about 1:1, that is also known as Ames technique. While trituration, you have to keep two things in mind. First and foremost, the grass pestle we have to use in a thumb and palm grass, and we have to move the pestle along the walls of mortar so that silver particles get coated with the mercury. Ensuring that the mercury, silver particles are coated completely with the mercury, then we have to take mix part onto the gauze piece and squeeze it. With this process, you remove excess mercury from the amalgam. The excess mercury should be collected on the motor. After complete squeezing, you have to take the material onto the gloves and do mulling. Index finger and palm. This is how the material looks after complete mulling. After mulling, you have to transfer this amalgam onto the tapping dish. With the help of amalgam carrier, you have to carry amalgam from the tapping dish to the cavity surface with an increment portion. After placing one first increment, you have to condense with the help of round and parallelogram condenser. After condensing this increment properly, then we have to move on to the second increment and condense it properly. While condensing, again the condenser should be along the long axis of truth and you should apply proper force, that is about 25 meters. When you condense it properly, then you can see that small amount of mercury is coming onto the occlusal surface or onto the surface of restoration. With the help of ball burnisher, you just have to burnish slightly onto the restoration. Ideal time for starting carving. So first and foremost, you should keep in mind when you should start carving. So after initial set, you should start carving. So when do you know? How do you know that your initial set have been occurred? So by moving an instrument, you can feel resistance while moving the instrument. Or the second point which you should remember that. While moving instrument, you will hear clicking sound. So this is the start of carving. With the help of three carvers, that is diamond or Franz carver, Hollenbach and Watts carver, you should start carving. The other important points that you should remember while carving are the working end of carver should be placed half onto the tool surface and half onto the restoration so that your carving will achieve proper contour as the tooth has. So first point that we should remove any excess amalgam which is present under the tooth structure with the help of spoon excavator. Followed by this, you have to start carving. You can use any type of carver whichever is comfortable. Just you have to keep in mind that half of the working end of carver should be onto the cusper inclination, that is onto the tool surface, and half onto the restoration. You have to move along the cusp on towards the central fissure from distal to mesial side or from mesial to distal side. You have to carve distal as well as mesial triangular fossa. You have to move from buccal as well as lingual cusper inclination so as to achieve carving on the buccal as well as lingual surface of the tooth. after complete carving, you can see that you this is a central group which you should carve the buccal as well as the lingual fissure, and you should bifurcate the central groove just before the marginal ridge into two halves so that you can carve distal as well as mesial triangular fossa. So after carving, your carving should be in a continuous flow with the cuspal inclination from buccal as well as lingual halves of occlusal surface.